Okay, another Patreon Q&A. Thank you again, patrons, so much for your support and also for the questions, really interesting questions we have today. I want to start again with the monthly Discord challenge. So if you are a Patreon, come join us on Discord. There is a dedicated Patreon Discord channel. Really interesting conversations, all sorts of different tips and tricks. And there is also a monthly challenge with giveaways. So if you are on Patreon, come join us on Discord. If you are not a Patreon, consider joining our little community there on Patreon and on Discord. It's quite fun. There are, again, giveaways, challenges, all sorts of different information, extra content, Patreon-only live streams, and so on and so forth. So what we have here, we have 5 submissions this month. And I gave each submission a note, basically. We have C, D, E, F, and G. And here in VCVREC, I have a burst generator that will trigger sample and hold, generating random voltage, going through a quantizer. I have here C, D, E, F, and G. And we can see the notes on the tuner, right? So I'm going to click to hit or to trigger the burst generator. It will generate 16 triggers. And then it will stop on one note, and this note will be the winner. So again, it's not a competition. It's selected by more or less random, or selected randomly more or less by sample and hold in this case. Right, so let's have a look. I'm going to click it, and E, the note E, which is E, Sikotzel or Sikozel. Cool, I will contact you on Discord. Sweet. Okay, so what I have here is basically a synthesizer, a synth voice that I build. I also saved it as a selection, as a preset. So I will upload it to Patreon. You can download it from there. And yeah, and load it in your patches and use it. So what I have here basically are 3 oscillators, so 3 even VCOs. I have a dual attenuverter. I have 2 of them actually, just for attenuating, inverting if there is a need. I have also a noise here, if you want to use noise, a mixer that we can mix those signals. A filter, all of this will go to a filter, low pass, band pass, or high pass. I have 2 envelopes, one will control the VCA, and another one I can use to control all sorts of different things. 2 LFOs, sample and hold. And I have here 3 loopers from Lilac. I thought in this case I will just go and loop a bit the sounds. And creating texture, I have here the mixer that I'm using to mix the loopers, and this is going through another filter because I like having filter at the end, just to so it's not always playing all the time, and of course some reverb. Right, so let's start with something, recording something, and then we will start with the first question or with the questions. Right, so let's say something like this. Let's mix a few waves. So I will use, let's say, an even waveform, right? And maybe a square wave, and maybe another square wave, right? Something like this. With the noise, we will wait for a second. This will go, let's say, to a low-pass filter, right? And I will send the VCA to the first looper, and now maybe I can play this. If I bring in the levers. Let's take one oscillator an octave down, or 2 octaves down. Let's say 2 octaves down. 2 octaves down and 1 octave down, and then, yeah. I will also detune them. Oh, they're already detuned a bit, I see. All right, cool, so they're a bit detuned. Just to add movement, what I can do is I can add also some pulse width modulation, right, with an LFO. So if I send the LFO, let's say, to the dual attenuverter, and from there to the pulse width modulation, PWM, let's make this a bit slower. Right. And I can invert them. Or invert the LFO. And we will use the second LFO to add some pitch modulation, right, through the FM. Let's say just to all of them, why not? Let's do this to all of them. Let's see how it sounds like. Just to have some movement, just a bit, if I do this too much. Right, so just a bit, tiny bit. Just to have the move. Change the envelope a bit. Let's have an envelope also for the filter, a different envelope, maybe with, you will see. Maybe no sustain. Longer attack. Okay, let's try and record a few notes, right? Just a few notes and see what happens. This one. Right? Here, by the way, the key step that I can use, so I didn't tell you this, the key step, as you can see here on the MIDI module, that I can use to play this voice. And I also have here the MIDI line, just a MIDI controller, some knobs that I can use. In this case, I'm using it already to control the cutoff of the last filter. Okay, so this is playing a bit. Let's start with the first question. Robert, hi Robert. I hope all is well. I often have trouble with making sounds fit or blend together. Can you suggest some VCV oscillator modules that blend together well to create a sonic palette? Additionally, ways to make sounds more interesting and cinematic, similar to your cinematic lead video. All right, so two questions. First of all, if I can recommend some oscillators that blend well together. All right, so I have something prepared, of course, but I think there is something that many people forget, me as well, I also forget it a lot, that pitch is frequency. And if you want things to blend well together, you have to think about your composition and how you compose and how you place your sounds in the frequency field, right? So for example, if you have many voices that are playing more or less the same notes, it will be harder for you to blend them together, right? So I think something that's really important is paying attention to what notes the different voices play, what space they take in the spectrum field, in the frequency field, right? If you have a lot of things in the low end, many voices in the low end, it will be harder for you to bring one to the front, right? On the other hand, if you have many in the mid, many in the high, so you have to spread them. And again, notes are frequencies, so if you have the same notes playing in different voices, they will clash together and it will be harder for you to blend. So I'm not so sure how much is it about the oscillators. I think it's more about the composition and how you arrange things spectrum wise, frequency wise. Because this will make it easier for you to blend things. But I have also something ready. If you go here up, I have a selection ready. Where is it? Edit, import, right? I have here oscillators. Hopla. Where is it? Ah, it's here down. You never know, right? So I have here a few oscillators that I use more often. Right, and I think, in my opinion, they sound great, and I use them again more often than other oscillators. I use also other oscillators, but those are the ones that I always go back to, and I think they sound together by themselves. And also, each of them is unique in its own way, and you can really use them for different sections of your composition, for bass, for treble, for mid, right, arpeggios and stuff like this, percussive sounds, more pads and stuff like this, right? So I have here, of course, a Blick and Basel from Wohl. They are small, they are small modules, which is great for bigger patches. They are CPU efficient, they sound amazing. You have a lot of sound design capabilities here, even though they are small, right? They are also polyphonic. There is also Vesek, which is a complex oscillator. So you have two oscillators basically, with FM, AM, folding, sync, and all sorts of different things. You can get crazy interesting sounds with it, and I really recommend exploring Vesek more. Also Squinky Labs, Saws and Kitchen Sink. So Squinky Labs, everything Squinky Labs sounds great, and also really CPU efficient. So it's great also if you want bigger patches, but your CPU is, or your computer or your setup is not so powerful, right? So Squinky Labs, and they sound amazing. CPU, but not in a price of sound. So you have Saws, which I love to use for bass mostly. It's a super saw oscillator with 7 saw oscillators that are a bit detuned. Really interesting oscillator. I recommend changing this from classic to clean. This will make sure there is even less aliasing. It will be a bit more CPU heavy, but still very CPU efficient. And also Kitchen Sink, which is based on one of my favorite oscillators, or synth voices actually, in VCV, which is the FM operator from Bog Audio. But in Kitchen Sink you have another interesting feature, which is the fold, or the triangle sign, right? So you can have also wave folding together with FM, which is also quite interesting. And of course the FM operator, which I use a lot. Again, it's more of a synth voice because it has also an envelope. You can create interesting sounds with one and interesting sounds with a few of them. And I love it for percussive stuff. I love it for pads, FM pads, all sorts of different voices. They even VCO, just like you've seen, I used now 3 of them. It just sounds amazing. I don't know why. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's a simple oscillator, but it sounds raw, I guess. I don't know how to explain this. This is just my opinion again. Energy from the Geodesics, which is an amazing, another synth voice. It has also a built-in VCA. It has no envelope actually, so maybe it's not a synth voice, but it has a VCA, built-in VCA that you can use. Ring modulation, really interesting sounds you can get from it. I also like using it for arpeggios, for all sorts of bukla-like sounds, I guess, if there is something like this. And Interzone, which is a full-on synthesizer from Valley that sounds brilliant. It has almost everything you need. I wish it had a few more CV inputs, but this is how it is. But still, it has an LFO, sample and hold, filter, sub-oscillator. You can mix different oscillators. We will see this also. There's another question. We will see this in the second part of this question, actually, about cinematic sounds, right? So I'm going to use this. You can blend in noise, it has an envelope, outputs, inputs, and all sorts of different things. So those are the voices or oscillators I use a lot, or most of the time. Just because I like them doesn't mean that they are good. Of course, there are many others that are amazing. It's just that I don't find myself need much more after, or many more oscillators after this. Of course, I experiment with other ones as well, but I usually come back to this collection and I just like using them. I also use a lot of the Instruo modules, but for now they are still not available in VCV2. So I could not show you them here. So also in Struer I use a lot. Yeah, so those are the oscillators. The second part was, let me go back to this, ways to make sounds more interesting and cinematic. So there are three things you can do. Let me just get rid of this. And I will load another selection. This selection thing is really interesting. What was it? Cinematic. And of course it opened somewhere else and you have to look for it. Oh, okay, it opened next to the mixer, which is great. So I'm going to already to connect this to the mixer. Right, and I just have to get rid here of the MIDI for a second, so I'm not playing both voices. Okay, so there are a few things that can really add interest to your sound and make things a bit more cinematic, a bit bigger, a bit more with weight. First of all, it's layering. Layer oscillators, just like I'm doing here with the oscillators and the noise, maybe later we'll also add, also with interzone I'm using here, you can layer a noise, a sub oscillator, other oscillator, a square wave and a saw wave. So layering, I think, is really important. It creates a much more interesting sound, more sound with more movement, I guess, right? So this is first of all. Second of all, again, adding movement, which means modulation, maybe slow modulation, maybe random slow modulation for pitch, right? Pitch modulation can add lots and lots of movement, just a bit. You don't need to make it as a full vibrato, but just a bit. Pulse width modulation. If you detune the oscillators like I did before, you also get interesting movement, right? So movement is another way. And what I think is important, especially if you want cinematic sounds, you think big sounds, is stereo field. Opalach, stereo field, right? So don't have less in mono, more spread out. If you listen on headphones, it sounds huge. Reverb is one of them. Reverb is really important to me. Of course, reverb is life. I use it a lot, but especially for sounds that I want them to sound huge, I add a huge reverb that will basically add to the effect. And also chorus. I like using also chorus to add this movement in the stereo field. Again, it's a sort of a, it will add also some pitch movement. So here I have the one from Flag, which I really, really like. Sounds amazing. So let's see how this sounds like before everything. What do I have here? Envelope. Yeah, I can control. Maybe I can do this maybe with a different controller. I will control the filter actually with, again, with the MIDI just. Right, so this is before. Right, basically we have a saw wave going through a filter. Right, now let's add a sub oscillator. Maybe I will close the first voice, okay, just so we can concentrate on this for a second. Let's do this here, right? Okay, let's concentrate on this here, right? So I added a, let's do this again. This is the voice. I add a sub oscillator, which is an octave down. Add some noise. In this case, white noise. Already it has more character, right? I can add also a pulse wave and then add some pulse width modulation. This is internally routed to the LFO. In this case here, right? Not needed for so much. Already there is movement. And then also pitch modulation. Right, again, so first you layer things, add movement with modulation, not too much, just a bit, right? And then you add some stereo widening, I guess. So here I have a chorus. If I take this all the way, the mix all the way up, we can listen to how it will affect. I want this to be on the full range of everything, right? A bit slower. Basically, it's a delay, so a bit slower delay time and more drive. Right, and now I can mix this in. Right? I wonder if the bypass works here with... let's see.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Right, so this is before. I just bypass the chorus. And after. Right, you can hear it adds lots and lots of space. And of course, reverb. I mean, you need reverb. So I'm not so sure what happened to plateau, but you should add just a bit because otherwise it just distorts. Listen to this. Right? Maybe even a bigger reverb. Maybe we'll take this an octave down. Right? And then you just have to play this. I like playing with the filter. Right, of course there is a lot more you can do with this to make this even bigger. What I will do now, for example, I will add a different oscillator, maybe another sub, sine wave or something like this to add even more weight. Maybe add another like a wavetable oscillator up somewhere. Again, make sure you are aware of the notes that it's playing, right? If you don't want everything to play the same note, or the same octave or the same register, right? So maybe a wavetable oscillator, even an octave higher than this. Really, opalach, really spread out in the stereo field, going left and right, just creating, you know, when you think something big, then it needs also a lot of weight and it needs also a lot of layers, right? So layering, modulation or movement and stereo field. So I think those three can really help you. I will save this, let me do this now. I will save this, everything, as a selection. Again, also this will be, let's Q&A cinematic. This will also be available on Patreon if you want to download this as a selection and open it in your patch, all free modules, free available modules, I should say, right? So you can also do this. I will just delete it now so it's not taking too much CPU and I will bring back this one here, right? And bring back the MIDI. And this was key step and this was MIDI low. Right, so I hope this was helpful, Robert. Thank you for your question. Let's have a look at the second question and then go back to our voice. I need another schluck of tea. All right. Hi, Cooper. Hi. Thank you for taking the time to put together all the videos. I appreciate it. And education services for us. Thank you, man. I appreciate it. I'm new to modular and still working around everything. One question I have is what might be the best way to use VCV as a full song device? I would like to create a few different chord progressions that I can trigger from some external MIDI pads. Pad A is chord progression 1, pad B is chord progression or melody 2, and so on. I'd love to use VCV Modular as a background band while I play other instruments live. Amazing idea. I have a few thoughts about this. Again, I have something prepared. We will see where it will open it. Let's see. Import selection. I have it here and it's opened. Where is it? It's not opened. Import selection again. Chords. Ah, it's there. Oh man, what's going on here? You have to look for it. All right. Okay, so first of all, my first thought, if you want to use VCV, I would not recommend, this is what I want to say, I would not recommend trying to use VCV Rec for creating full songs and arranging things. First of all, because I don't think VCV Rec is, or modular at all is made for something like this. And I mean with modules, of course, during the performance, of course, but with modules, I don't think it was made for this. And second of all, if you do want to do this, it is possible, but you need many modules, a lot of time to invest in it. And again, many modules that might make your page much bigger, drain more CPU and so on. If you really want to create songs, I would recommend getting the VCV VST, loading it in something like Reaper, for example, or any other DAW that you might enjoy, and creating the arrangement there. VCV for sequencing, for sound design if you want, and then the DAW for arranging and really creating the songs. Because I think it will take, it is possible, but it will take way too many modules and experimentation. And it's like a huge, so it will become like a huge Sudoku that you have to remember what is going where and what is triggering what and where it's, because I don't think modular and especially also VCV rack is made for something like this. I think a DAW will be much easier. That said, if you want something simple, like having a few chord progressions, I will do this just a second. A few chord progressions and switching between them, then you can use something like the triggered switch from ML or any other switch you might want. This will work perfectly well. To switch between chord progressions and melodies and stuff like this. So let's say, for example, this is not about how to create chord progression, this chord progressions, this is about how to switch between them. So let's say that here I have one chord progression, right, with a chord key from Impromptu, and here I have another chord progression, right, and I want with my MIDI, whatever, MIDI pads or MIDI buttons or something else, to switch between them. Right, so the triggered switch, basically you have 8 inputs, so you can have up to 8 chord progressions and an output. This will go to what you are sequencing. Right, so let's say that I have here, for example, one chord progression and another chord progression. And then with the MIDI to gate module, you can assign your pads, right? They will output notes basically. So let's say that one pad will trigger the first chord progression, another pad will trigger the second one. Right, and like this, you can switch between the chord progressions. Of course, again, you can have up to 8, right? And trigger and switch between them. So this is something you can use, the triggered switch from ML. You can use other switches to make this also automatically for you with the division of the clock. This might be quite fun. But again, if you want, I recommend that if you want to create full songs and arrangements, I recommend getting the VST. Now it's out, it's about, and you can really load it in your DAW. If you don't have a DAW and you want a DAW just for recording and arranging, not for composing and sound design, I really recommend Reaper. It works really easily in Reaper. It's really low on CPU, or really low on your system, let's say light on CPU, light on your system, right? And you can just use it to record and to arrange things, so you don't have to use it in VCV. But the solution is in VCV, I guess it's a triggered switch. You hit a pad, it will switch to a different chord progression, right? So I will delete this now. I hope this was helpful, right? Let me know if there is anything else I can help with. Okay, let's add another voice, right? I will change this to the second looper. Let's add maybe a nice bass, maybe. Right, so let's see. Okay, I need, first of all, because I have this closed, just a second. Take the first voice down for a second. All right. Okay. And let's do this. I don't want the pitch modulation for the bass in this case. And let's use, instead of the even output, let's use a saw wave. I will use the sustain all the way. I'm just going to record this drone a bit with some movement on the LFO. So let's use the LFO. just a bit. And now it's time to add some noise, so let's add white noise. Right, and what I can do, I can use the sample and hold to change the frequency, of the LFO a bit. Right. This is without. The movement in the pulse width is quite interesting. Alright, so let's just record this a bit. Now it will just loop, right? I'm not playing this anymore, this is from the looper. Maybe I can add another layer, maybe a sort of a power chord, right? I will add a G. Basically a fifth above this note. Right. Again, this is just now the looper. Let's mix it in the first voice. So here in the right-click menu, there is having the input at negative 18 dB, which I hope will help. If not, I will have to change this to supermassive. But it's okay. Right, so we have some texture. Okay, another schluck of tea. This bass is nice. Okay. The next question. Jonathan, hey! So I posed that someone, not the original developer, is having build errors with Lifeform Modular Modules and V2. I then noticed in the description of percussive vibration and additive vibration that they are both based on the 21 kHz palm loop oscillator and Befako Rampage. Is it possible to come close to the sound and functionality of either of those Lifeform Modular Modules using palm loop and Rampage? I know this is very specific, but sounds like it would be a great exercise. So first of all, it's a great idea and a great exercise indeed. I have again something saved. Let me see now where it will open it. What do you say, up or down? How did I call it? Percussive vibration. Let's see, where is it? Here. All right. Okay. So what I have here. All right. So here what we have. Here we have the percussive vibration. I will concentrate on this one because it's way easier and then you can get it from there. So what do we have here? We have basically an oscillator, right? We have an oscillator. We have a filter. We have a noise source and we can change this from a sine wave. We can morph between a sine wave of the oscillator and the noise. We have FM. Right, and we have a few envelopes. We have an envelope for the VCA, we have an envelope for the pitch bending, we have an envelope for accent that we can send wherever we want, and we have another envelope for the filter. Right, now we have also width. I'm not so sure what it is, what width is. Maybe it's pulse width modulation, I'm not so sure, but it doesn't matter in this case. because this is what I have here. I have the palm loop oscillator, right? That we can use its sine wave, and we can send this to a crossfader. This is one is from Bog Audio, right? And we can use also some noise. Let's do this for a second. We will not listen to this also, but right, and we can use noise. And now I can hear morph between them. A will be just the a sine wave, B will be just the noise, or everything in between. Right, so you can really scan through those two waves. Then you have a filter. In this case, I'm using tangents. I think it's an amazing filter, a Lopez filter in this case. Right, then it goes to a VCA, and we have four envelopes. In this case, I'm using Rampage because this is what is being used there. Rampage, really nice, plucky envelopes. And you have four of them. You have two Rampages, four envelopes. One will be for the VCA, one will be for the filter, one will be for the pitch, right? And another one that you can use wherever you want, you can route it wherever you want. Let's have a look at this again. Right, you have the trigger, you can trigger it separately, and then you just take it from the output and modulate whatever you want within the module or outside of it. Right, so you have here another envelope that you can use. Now, if you don't want to use two Rampages, maybe it's too big, maybe you are already using Rampage for something else. I think it's a sort of a waste to use Rampage just for an envelope. So you can use four AD envelopes from Nisci. First of all, four of them will be smaller than even one Rampage. And also they are really snappy and percussive, so you can use them also for this voice, right? So basically you have here more or less the basics of the percussive vibration. You can add FM, you can add pitch modulation or pitch envelope, right? Modulate the filter, add noise. So other than the width, that again, I'm not so sure what it's doing. Maybe you can send it to a wave folder even, maybe that's the width. Right, you can have whatever you want. There is also velocity. So for velocity, we need another VCA basically, right? So you send the voice after everything, you send it to another VCA, and then here you have velocity right through the CV input. So basically you have the percussive vibration. I think you can use other modules as well, although the palm loop and Rampage sound amazing. Again, the AD envelope, it sounds really well, and you can use other oscillators. As far as I see it, only a sine wave is being used here, right? So you can use also other oscillators and experiment. I think the magic comes from the four envelopes, right? Because you have a VCA, you have the pitch bend that you can set, and you have also an accent that you can add to almost everything. So it's really interesting. So this is more or less what it is. I will disconnect the cables, right? And maybe this I will leave. This also I will leave here. Actually, you know why did I disconnect it? Actually, it should be like this. And one for the VCA, right? And I will save this again as a collection, and you can change it with the AD. Again, this will be available on Patreon if you're interested. And you can download it and use it and see what you get out of it. It can be a really interesting experiment. Cool. So let's have a look at another question. Jonathan, thank you. I hope this was helpful. Guy, hi, Guy Shaham. In case I want to use MPE in VCV2 as standalone and not in Bitwig, and considering Modis with its MPE module still in port to VCV2, maybe a survey of the new MPE mode of the fundamental MIDI modules. All right. First of all, yes, I really want to go deeper into MPE. But I checked it, I experimented, and it works, and it works. There are good news and bad news. The good news is that it works. The bad news is that in my system, in my setup, I tried it and it crashes after a few seconds. So maybe it's a bug, maybe it's something on my system, maybe it will be fixed soon. But basically what you have to do, you need two modules. You need the MIDI to CV, and you need the MIDI CC to CV, right? So MPE, basically what you have, multi. MIDI polyphonic expression, right? You have different channels for each note. So here in the right click menu of the MIDI to CV, you have polyphony mode. You have to change this to MPE, and then you will have velocity, and you will have aftertouch also, polyphonic aftertouch, right? I have the sensor morph. I think you also have the sensor morph. I tested it, it works, just that it crashes after a few tries. So I'm not so sure, maybe it's just my system, maybe there is something else open here with MIDI, I'm not so sure. Try it, it works. And also in the MIDI to CC module, there is also MPE mode, you have to select it, and then you just go to one slot, and you enter 74, right? This is the MIDI CC MPE number 74 that allows you, if you have the sensor morph, right, with the finger, if you go up and down, this is also polyphonic and it works. So you need those two modules, change them to MPE, make sure you have 74 selected, right? And then it will work for you. You can use the sensor morph in VCV standalone with MPE. You have polyphonic expression, MIDI polyphonic expression, and it works. I cannot show this to you. I tried, but again, it crashes. So I cannot show it to you, but it works. So give it a try. Maybe for you, it will work better than it worked for me. All right, let's add another layer, maybe a sort of an arpeggio, I guess. So let's do this. All right, let's first of all disconnect all of the cables. We'll start from fresh, and then we'll soon start with another question. Let's get rid of this. I will use in this case a bandpass filter maybe, and I will use the third. Looper, and let's do this. I will use, let's say, just two oscillators. I will use two even waveforms. Let's listen just to this for a second, right? And let's use sample and hold to modulate the cutoff point. I will use smooth random signals in this case. And maybe also some noise to add some more interest here. Okay, but I need something more percussive, right? So the envelope for the velocity, no sustain. Let's get rid of the modulation for a second, just to concentrate on the envelope. And let's make this a bit more punchy. If I add some pitch modulation for the oscillators with the envelope, right, we might get a bit more punchy. So I need to send the envelope first to an attenuator because there is no attenuator on the even VCO. No attack, short attack. Right, I want a really short envelope. Going to modulate the FM on both oscillators. And maybe the same envelope can also control the noise. So the noise is not always there. It will be just with the envelope again, just to add punch. Yeah. Right, without the noise, with, right? Without pitch envelope modulation. with, just to add a bit more punch. Maybe that's a bit too much. Maybe an octave up. And let's bring back the filter modulation. Right? And let's see how I can record. This is already there. Okay, sorry. Yeah, let's record this. Okay, for now the filter is all the way up. Another question. Oscar, hi Omri, would you consider making more fixed systems, specifically low CPU systems? I like to work on my little laptop, but it's not very powerful. Cheers, Oscar, thank you. Yes, I'm just waiting for VCV2 to be a bit more stable, that everything will work without any bugs or issues or whatnot, and also that the modules are a bit more stable. For example, Plateau is not working totally fine. Other modules sometimes crash. MIDI mapping is not really working. So I'm waiting for VCV basically to be more stable, and then I will go back and making more videos like this with fixed systems. Something like this, a fixed synthesizer that you can work with and work for sound design. So yes, the answer is yes indeed. The next one is another one from Oscar. Also, what would you recommend for someone who wants to get their first pieces of hardware? My budget is not too big, but I would like to start to get away from the screen a bit. Okay, so I'm not going to answer this about Eurorack, about modular, because I have many questions. If you want to start with modular, then there are many things that it will depend on. You want sound design, you want sequencing, you want to start small and stay small, you want to start small and in the future have a bigger system. You want to work only with hardware, like you say, to stay away from the screen, or you want to combine it also at some point and record at least on the laptop or use VCV rack with it. So many questions. But if it, you are not, if you don't mean about modular, if you mean about just hardware in general, I really recommend getting something like the MicroFreak from Arturia. Right, it's a full-on synthesizer. There are many interesting sound design things you can do with it. Many different wave shapes, many different synthesis types. It has a unique keyboard that you can use. You can also use it with VCV if you want. You can use it later on with other hardware. It has also CV outputs. Really interesting modulation matrix. You can really sit with it and spend hours playing with it. And trying all sorts of things, really interesting presets that you can explore and learn from. You can just plug your headphones into it and that's it, you don't need anything. It's also powered by USB, so you can take it also with you out if you want, right? Go to the woods and play with the MicroFreak. One thing, it has also a sequencer and arpeggiator. One thing that is it's really missing are effects, basically. So I recommend getting something, maybe something like the Zoom multi-effect pedal. This is the MS-70 CDR. Something, you know, that you have some delay and reverb and stuff like this. Because it really needs effects. I mean, it sounds okay by its own, but it needs this, it needs effects. There is no running away from it. So maybe something like a multi-effects pedal or another, some other, or if you want, the easiest will be if you can maybe just connect it to your laptop and use effects on the laptop. It will be the cheapest, I guess. But this will not get you all the way out from the laptop. But still, I think the MicroFreak is a great way to start with hardware. It's polyphonic, you can create chords. I have it, I still use it. I sample it a lot. I send it to all sorts of different modules that I have. And yeah, it's great. You can explore it for hours and days and months. It just needs some effects and that's it. But it's great, it has also a vocoder, noise engineering, oscillators, all sorts of different interesting things. So I really recommend starting with the MicroFreak. And again, this is in case you are not speaking about starting Eurorack or starting modular, because then it's a whole different story. I think this was the last question. So let's just add maybe a solo of something that I can just play without looping. Maybe not, because the filter is there at the end. Is already distorting. Never mind, I think we will leave it at this. It's an hour long video almost. I hope it was helpful. Again, come, if you're a patron, come join us on Discord. If you're not a patron, come join us on Patreon. It's fun, it's great, it's inspiring, I hope. Again, different collections will be selections, as it's called, presets will be available on Patreon if you want to download them and use them. Thank you again, patrons, for your questions. Thank you so much for your support. And Mike, you are in my way all the time. That's it. Cheers.